Have you guys ever heard of the Almas?
What?
No.
The Almas of Mongolia?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah.
Shit. I was, like,
I was thinking of the Mariachi band.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean John? Yeah, I know him.
You know Almas. You know John Almas?
No, his name is John Connor. Not to be confused with the main character from the movie series, The Terminator.
You guys need to start, like, branching out from your name choices. It's all very confusing. It starts to get very, like, muddied.
No, it's all. It seems like it's all 80s pop culture reference. I guess they are children of the 80s.
No, John, air quotes, the Almas, Connor. He's my...
No.
Jesus Christ.
I haven't heard of that guy.
He's my best concrete guy.
Oh, really?
Of course he is.
No shit.
You know, I'd like to employ all of the big feats, all of the Sasquatches, all of the what have yous.
So, you're saying there's different, I guess, genuses? Is there, like, are you all different cultures? What's the deal?
Well, I mean, I guess there's a whole lot of type of human beings, right?
Oh, shit. I didn't think about it like that.
We are so not woke.
Damn.
Yeah, very narrow-minded.
Right?
You guys ain't straight 100. Bigfoot keeps it real. All day.
I thought you were a Sasquatch.
High up in the Caucasus and Pamir Mountains of Central Asia and the Altai Mountains of Southern Mongolia, people have reported sightings of a certain wild man. More human than ape, and they call it the Almas. This area of the world is hostile and unforgiving. Treacherous mountain ranges and bleak winters do not make it a welcoming area to live.
This is Central Asia?
This is Central Asia, the Altai Mountains of Southern Mongolia.
Mongolia.
Almas are said to be over 6 feet tall and covered in reddish-brown fur. They are bipedal, so that means they walk on 2 feet, with anthropomorphic facial features such as pronounced brow ridges, flat noses, and no chin. And sadly, they are described as hairy and stinky and mute.
Oh. Hairy, stinky, and mute. That's the worst dating profile I've ever seen.
But
just gotta put it out there.
Huge heart.
Yeah.
Just the biggest heart.
Biggest hearts and living in Paleolithic squalor.
any gamer, professional hacker.
John's got a drinking problem. He lives in squalor right now. He's not proud of it. He knows.
Jesus.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
God damn it.
Started it. Though close to the Himalayan mountain range, the Almas are not considered to be anything like the Yeti in terms of intelligence and behavior. They are thought of as a relic population of human ancestors. They use tools and communicate using gestures. Occasionally, they have been seen wearing animal fur as clothing during winter.
So they're a highly advanced species, so they have tools, obviously. They can craft clothing.
Yes, they are kind of considered very close to the Homo erectus. Native traditions dating back hundreds of years claim the exchange of trade goods between Mongolian villages and the Almas. There are also drawings of these beings in Tibetan apothecary books, which are said to only include valid species recognized in the region. They're actually in these, like, medicinal books.
Like an encyclopedia, like an old ancient Mongolian encyclopedia. That's amazing.
And also commercial economic books because they were trading.
They were trading with,
them.
Correct.
That's crazy.
In the mid 15th century, Bavarian nobleman Hans Schildberger was fighting the Ottoman Empire and taken prisoner. After the Battle of Ankara in 1402, he was released and he followed Timur the Lame to Uzbekistan and then Timur's son into Siberia and Mongolia. By 1427, he had returned to Bavaria and wrote about his journey. In his writing, he describes two different creatures, the Almas and the Przewalski horse of Mongolia. Both species, whose existence was doubted, until later the Przewalski horse was verified as actually living, only to make one suspect that he wasn't lying about the Almas either. One of the most popular stories told was from the 1880s. Russian investigators Igor Butsev, Dmitry Bayanov, Alexander Mashovskis, and Boris Porshnev in 1964 collected over 100 accounts of the capture and taming of an Almas woman.
Nice.
Ooh.
It's not clear how she was captured, but she was taken in by a nobleman named Edgy Ganaba and kept in a village in an enclosure because it was said that she acted like a wild beast.
So this was an actual report filed?
Yeah, so in 1964, these Russian investigators, Russian historians, looked into a story from the 1880s.
Oh, okay.
Gotcha.
You said there were 100, over 100 accounts?
Over 100 accounts of this woman.
100 accounts?
Yes.
So it's like a feral person.
Yeah, basically, good. Yes.
Like Nell.
She's treated kind of like Nell. Jacob May.
Jesus.
Fortunately, and eventually, she was given more freedom. She was described to have all the features of the Almas. Reddish brown fur, very tall and muscular, and a flat nose. She didn't speak and preferred to sleep in the ground. She was given tasks such as grinding grain into flour and bringing home firewood and water. Her teeth could crack walnuts. She could run as fast as a horse and swim across treacherous rivers.
Like a beaver.
She was named Zana, and Zana eventually had sexual relations with her owner.
Of course.
Edgy Ganaba.
Come on, Edgy.
We can all see that happening. That was going to happen.
Thanks to Edgy, she gave birth to many children, most of whom sadly died in infancy. But four of her children did survive and assimilated into normal society, looked like regular humans, married, and had families of their own. DNA samples were later taken from Zana's living relatives to find that she was 100% sub-Saharan African, but not of any known group. It was believed her ancestors had left Africa 100,000 years before and had lived in the Caucasus region and who may have been the original Almas people.
Wow.
Interesting. Actual science behind something. That's nice to hear.
In 1964, same year, more accounts from Russian historian Boris Porchnev portray Almas to have cone-shaped skulls and teeth structure similar to humans, just with wider canines.
Is that similar to the Peruvian skulls that are kind of elongated like aliens?
Or a little bit, yeah.
It kind of looks like the classical like H.R. Giger alien look from the... Was that Ridley Scott?
Yep.
Yeah, so that kind of elongated head?
No, just more like upright, you know, like more like the cone head from
cone
like,
head.
You know,
head,
like...
Cone heads.
Yeah, cone gotcha. Heads.
Aykroyd.
Dan Aykroyd. I was like, who the hell is that guy's name? Yeah. Boris also said he actually encountered direct descendants of the Almas, groups of families living in holes in the ground. He said they were human-like with excellent swimming, remember?
Oh.
And running abilities and a foul odor.
Always!
Even as recent as 1992, Russian cryptozoologist Dr. Marie-Jean Kaufman and Frenchman Sylvain Palix gathered data using hair samples, footprints, and droppings, supporting that the Almas were large hairy creatures weighing as much as 500 pounds, nocturnal, and could run as fast as 40 miles per hour.
Whoa! It's pretty freaking fast!
So, do the Almas exist? Or are they just stinky hairy introverts who prefer the solitude of a good hole in the ground?
So that's interesting. So,